all your favorite letters. CFL, NHL, NBA, MLB, NFL. All on the RPS. It's the Rod Pedersen Show.
And KBO. Korean Baseball Organization. Welcome, everybody, to the Rod Pedersen Show. Why do I have an echo in my ear?
I was just going to say. I got one, too.
Can we look into that, guys? And from our viewers, can you please let us know if that echo is just in my ear or if you're getting it, too? Here we go. People are writing in saying good morning from Windy AF Regina. That's Dallas writing in. I didn't think it was that bad driving up here in Big Bird today. You noticed the yellow Jeep up front?
I did. No, I didn't think it was that bad either. I mean, a little windy, but no big deal.
Oh, man. What's going on? I think we got rid of the echo. I just put my earphone back in. Black screen. Okay, Nelson writes it and says, no echo. Okay, can we start again?
Good morning.
Good morning, Canada. Welcome to the Rod Pedersen Show, Canada's morning sports talk show. I'm your host, Rod. He's the co-host, Darren. How you doing, Dukes?
I'm great. How are you?
Did you find it windy on the way in here today?
Yeah, no, I didn't.
Good.
Boy, looking good, though.
We got a lot to get to today. I like this one. Jay Adams writes in, good afternoon from Ohio. Sixth largest region for viewership of the Rod Pedersen Show is the state of Ohio.
Wow.
And hang on, Ohio, that football mad state. I got something for you coming up. It's a really big hockey show today, by the way. Look at this guest list. Jason Strudwick, longtime NHLer. I think of him as an Oiler, but Islander, Vancouver Canuck, now of TSN Radio Edmonton. Struds is going to be with us, and a Rider fan. Tim Hunter, Stanley Cup champion with the Calgary Flames in 1989, most recently the head coach of the Moose Jaw Warriors. And a good friend of yours, Tim Hunter, will be with us. And Reed Lowe from St. Louis, the former Warrior, the former Minot Top Gun, who just randomly was watching my Facebook story one night and wrote me and said, listen, if you ever want a guest, if you're that hard up, I'd love to come on. Reed Lowe from the Show Me State.
Wow.
So that's going to be great. And, of course, our good friend Rich Sutter in an interview brought to you by Original 16. Would you guys mind putting up the comment if you can find it, Clark? They're rolling in like crazy, like a slot machine right now. But from Adam Stewart, he wrote in from the tractor cab. There's something that I want to mention about his comment with regards to what he's missing right now. And I'll address that. I got a lot of things to get to in the rollout here for Flooring Superstore. The quick six show topics could have got to about 10. Actually, the top 10 show topics. But number one, the CFL town hall reaction. We're going to get to that because CFL fans from across the land are talking about the commissioner, Randy Ambrosi, what he said yesterday, that the Grey Cup won't be in Saskatchewan, the festival in 2020. It's going to come back in 2022. I got more on that. That led to our poll question, by the way, today for Capital Auto Mall, Universal Collision Center. Do you believe there will be CFL games in 2020? The vote is like right down the middle. I put it up about 90 minutes ago. Like 51% yes, 49% no. And then it flips. And that's all close. This country is divided on whether the CFL is going to play games or not. So we'll get to that. And that'll be our theme. Even though it's a hockey show today, that'll be our poll question. And you see on Facebook, what is it? 59% say yes, 41% say no. Jeff, the Stampeders fan, writes in from Calgary. He says, morning, Rod. Followed your recommendation and watched Boys on the Bus last night. What a great documentary. Shows Gretzky in a light you don't always see. That's for sure. And by the way, I got a story about Paul Coffey. Since it's a hockey show, I got to tell you Paul Coffey's thoughts on Boys on the Bus. You haven't seen it yet, right?
No.
We did a dinner together in Zenon Park, Saskatchewan, and Coff had some thoughts on Boys on the Bus. It's so good. Here's Adam Stewart writing in. A great Saskatchewan comment here. He says, good morning from the tractor cab. Got to admit, I'm sure missing hearing training camp updates, Stanley Cup results, and MLB scores. Do you think that games for all sports will be better attended, worse attended, or about the same when the COVID-19 pandemic is over? Adam, I'm going to tell you this. I miss it too. Here's my tip. Think about something else. I don't say that flippantly. I don't say that glibly. Think about something else. To sit and wallow in what you miss, waste of time. Fair?
Absolutely.
Completely out of your control, Adam. Think about something else. And with regards to attendance at games, look, the more I read, the players don't want to come back. because of health reasons. And they're getting paid.
Yeah.
So what do you think, the fans going to pay money to be at risk? No, it's not good. It will affect attendance, of course. Point two, with the Randy Ambrosi saying that it'll be a shortened season if they play at all, I wonder how does that impact the teams from a Rough Riders perspective, of course, because that's my team. They were 13-5 last year, first place in the West. You flip and look at Hamilton, 15-3, first place in the East. You can see now why the really good NHL teams in this new playoff format is like, this hurts us. We worked our ass off to have a great franchise, and you're going to put some Rudy Poo teams in here, a bunch of Morley boys that could upset us in a round robin or a best of three? Do you think the Riders and Ticats would be thinking the same thing? I could see if they were.
Sure. If you let everybody in.
Right.
Like, you look at BC last year. They got hot towards the end of the year. They got everything sorted out. Didn't earn it throughout the year, you know, if they would have been considered a playoff team. But, heck, they ended up getting pretty close. And so if all of a sudden you let them in and they're riding, you know, a nice little streak at the end, yeah, I can see you'd be upset if you're at the top, for sure. And you've earned it throughout a long season.
Exactly. Nick Nielsen checking in today from the Energy City. Good morning, Rod. He's the voice of the Weyburn Red Wings. He says, what have you thought about the UFC's showing in the last couple weeks while there hasn't been other sports going on? I think it's been absolutely fantastic. I watched it all. Watched it all out of Jacksonville. I paid the $65 for UFC 249. I watched the two free fight nights, and I loved it. What people don't understand, I think you know, I've done a lot of combat sports announcing, boxing and MMA in my career. Just, I've never really publicized it. I guess I should have, but I'm a fan.
Yeah.
And now that I've got the time, I'm following all sports. But I love what Dana White's doing. I've been blasted by friends who have said, how can you support Dana White for what he's doing? He's just greedy. So is everybody, man. Move along. I'm entitled to my opinion. Quick other points. Remember I said, this is point three, USA Today did their annual NFL wins prediction.
Yes.
I love it every year. They're not always right, but it's something. And it's their NFL beat writers that all put their stuff together and they do a poll. I didn't write down the Titans, but I'll say this. Cowboys, they're predicting 10 wins. Chris Jones.
Yep.
Cleveland Browns, 7. That would be a one-win improvement from last year. Which they predicted last year they'd win 9, which would have got them into the playoffs, but of course they didn't. Brady's Buccaneers, 10 wins. Bills, Patriots, 8. So the USA Today NFL pundits predict that Tom Brady's Buccaneers will have more wins than the Patriots. So I'm just going to float that out there. This will be more of a football discussion tomorrow. We'll get more into it. Point four, by the way. Tiger Woods and Peyton Manning are the whopping favorites over Phil Mickelson and Tom Brady in that match play event that's coming up this Sunday. The 2-2.
Yeah.
Vegas line, whopping favorites, Tiger and Manning. My guess is Tiger is the whopping favorite over Phil Mickelson and Tom Brady.
Yeah.
Fair?
I would agree with that.
Don't you think Manning and Brady are like a wash?
You would think.
Golf-wise.
They both golf. They're both going to be pretty good. Like, they're going to hit good shots. But yeah, it'll come down to Tiger versus Phil. And Tiger lost last time. So he's going to be out to...
Oh, yeah.
And you don't want to play against the Mad Tiger.
No. The Tiger King? Is that what you're referring to?
Sure.
But Phil Mickelson was trashing Tiger. I don't know if you were watching Get Up. I saw it this morning. Phil's like, hey, we're playing this at Tiger's course. We're going to beat him, and we're going to create a bad memory for him every time he goes into his home course.
You're going to go into his building.
You wonder why people don't like Phil.
Yeah.
John Kirby writes in from Edmonton. He says, are you updated that Saskatchewan has to wait till 2022 for the Grey Cup? What? We heard. Nick Nielsen in Estevan, by the way, writes in and he says, you actually announced a fight for a friend of mine in Regina, Matt Fedler. Yes, I did, Nick. If I recall, I don't think Matt won that fight. You tell me if I'm wrong, but that was a lot of fun. That was Saturday Night Fights 3, I believe. When they carried one of the patrons out and put a bag over his head. And I said to the cops, why are you putting a bag over his head? And they said, so he doesn't spit on anybody. I love MMA events.
Wow.
Getting sidetracked. Point five, ran into a Pats alum in the co-op grocery store yesterday. And I'm just going to name him because he said he watches the show every day. Matt Struby. His dad, Todd, Pats great, Blades great, former Edmonton Oiler, had a pretty good visit with Strubes yesterday. And what do you think we talked about?
Oh, I can only imagine.
Hockey, and whether there's going to be hockey. And his thing was, he played a lot of... He's Jordan Eberle's best friend. I believe Eberle was in Strubey's wedding party or vice versa, or maybe both. But they're big buddies. And he just goes, man, we got to get in to watch these games. I want to see Bedard. And I'm like, you and me both, Strubes. Which really tells you, by the way, which we just reiterated in my mind, the importance of the players. Period. They're who we pay to go see. And then that was echoing in my mind all afternoon about how, I'm sorry, I just got to say, Randy Ambrosi goes to the House of Commons and the officials say, well, how much are the players going to get? We haven't worked that out yet. Come on, you guys. I know we're past that, and Randy acquitted himself very well in the town hall yesterday, but it's the damn players. That's all that matters. And are they being looked after in every sport? They're not, by the way. They're not.
That is it. You're absolutely right. It is the players. It's the players we go watch, the players we go see. And that's the people who are going to get hurt the most in all of this, because the leagues will still be there. For the most part, I would imagine all of the teams will still be there. It's the players who won't. They have short careers, right? And especially in junior. I mean, if the WHL doesn't play, that's a year of Connor Bedard.
Oh, yeah.
And he's not playing at 19, or he may not even play at 18, 19, or 20 years old. So you're already having a short window with him, and now you don't get him for a year. That sucks. So, yeah.
Totally sucks.
You got to think about the players.
There was, I guess it was the boys from the Unofficial Pats podcast, I think, yesterday. No, it started in Seattle, and then they retweeted it. It was some Thunderbirds fan group that said, would you pay a season ticket for your season ticket, even if you couldn't get into the building, and watch streaming all year for free? My season tickets are $1,000. I upgraded this year into luxury suite. So $2,000 actually for the two. I don't know. How many times have I said I just go to the games to socialize? I mean, the hockey's I just go to see my friends. I'm not sure I would like that deal.
That's why you go to the game. It's an experience.
Yes.
You're not going to pay the same amount of money to have that experience at home. Yeah, I know. It's got to be. I mean, what you pay for streaming right now is what you pay. You're not going to pay that extra money because there's going to be other things available for your time that cost a whole lot less and give you the same amount of enjoyment.
Yeah, you're not going to pay, I think, the more I think about it. Point six in the quick six show topics here. Clarification on the CFL statement yesterday, which they don't need to clarify anything. I'll say it again. They did a great job of their announcement yesterday of our options. A, they're going to confirm a season. B, they're going to cancel the season. Or C, say nothing. It was not all of them. It was maybe a combination of A and B.
Yeah.
But I saw a clip from the Calgary CTV Supper News last night where the anchor says, oh, and over to the CFL, Glenn, it looks like there's going to be a season. And Glenn Campbell, good friend of mine, CTV sportscaster, Calgary, the Rhinestone Cowboy, says, no, they're hoping, Connie, or what? But you know what I mean? People are just hearing with half an ear. Yes. And I heard it a lot in the last 12 hours, almost 24 hours. Oh, they're playing. That's what they got out of that. And that's not even Randy's fault.
No.
I'm just clarifying. No. He's saying, at best, if we play it September. And frankly, I just can't see it. With the border closure, players having to apply to the American players having to apply to the Canada and U.S. government to be deemed essential workers, which might not even happen. The guarantee that the stadiums will be safe and the training facilities and the living quarters from the virus. And let's not forget the federal aid debate. If they don't get that money, then what? There are so many roadblocks. Now, I want it to happen. But if I had to vote today, whether they're playing or not, I got to vote no.
I know. There's just so much that is working against them. And we can be in our own world, in our own province, in our own little place, and think that it's not so bad. It's getting better everywhere, right? That's the idea, is that in Alberta, BC, they're starting to get better. You know, Manitoba, Saskatchewan are doing okay. One case.
That's it.
That's all it takes, is one case.
Take it all down.
The whole thing will come crumbling down.
Stacy Champagne writes in. He says, thanks for the reminder. I got to go upgrade my Pats tickets today. Hey, you're welcome, Pats. No charge. God's team. I mentioned the everybody's getting into point one here on the CFL town hall and how this is going to work. Let me just say my extra points here. Rockstar of the day yesterday was Dave Jamieson. Those guys at TSN 1260 Edmonton really get behind our polls. If any one of their guys is on our show, they retweet it to all their listeners in Edmonton to get their guy to win. So Dave Jamieson will win the ball cap for Rockstar of the Day for Rockstar Supply Chain Solutions. And I know that he will wear it proudly around Edmonton.
That's awesome.
Probably even to Oilers games and so forth. Korean baseball scores. I didn't even bring it up yesterday because my team sucks. And frankly, I was losing interest in my Wyverns. But they won. The one night I don't check on the scores, they snap a 10-game losing streak. Everybody was writing in yesterday saying, hey, your Wyverns won. I didn't even know. I didn't even look. But anyways, here's the scores last night. Hey, Jordan, your Wiz took a whiz last night. They lost 9-4 to the Eagles. That's your team, right?
Yeah.
The Eagles. Craig Smith, our director of scouting, his Twins beat the Lions 2-0. Who cheers for the Tigers? Nobody's picked the Tigers on our board here.
No. Nope.
Tigers beat the Giants 6-1. The Dinos beat Clark's Bears 12-6. And the Wyverns lost again. 9-8 to Justin Dunk's Heroes.
It was short-lived.
Short-lived winning streak. Monty wants to know, how are my Bears? Your Bears, Monty, are in a tie for second with 8 wins with the Twins and the Heroes and the Dinos, whom nobody's claimed on our board, right? Right. Nobody's claimed them. They're 11-2. John Ohm in Winnipeg. Writes in, Wiz. Can't find a bathroom, John? By the way, the batting average leader hitting him out at 442 is Preston Tucker of the Tigers. We've got a new home run leader. It's Roberto Ramos of the Twins. He's got 6 round trippers.
Okay.
The big donger, don't know what's going on with him. I'm disappointed.
This has never happened before.
What?
That the donger's disappeared.
Yeah, no kidding. And there's the wins leader in pitching with 3 is Che Wang Choi of the Lions. So there's your Korean baseball update. I know we got to get to the last 2 points real fast here before we bring on Jason Strudwick. Went for that massage yesterday. That's why I missed the town hall.
Yeah.
I wish they could have scheduled the town hall around my massage that I had scheduled for 1 o'clock.
We forgot to let them know.
Right. But I went into the Evolution Fitness where I go to get my massage. She's got to change clothes between every customer. They change her clothes. She's got the visor. She's got the mask. You know how much I love my steam? They said there will not be a steam until a vaccine's found. Yeah. You should see his face. It's like mine. No steam. No steam for you until there's a vaccine. So that's why I'm getting a steam put in my house. Can't do it. My face, every time I shave, I look like I've got smallpox. You've seen it.
Yeah.
I can't do it. My face is all blotchy. I need the steam. And Trevor Harris messaged me last night, the quarterback for the Edmonton Eskimos, by the way. Clark handles pretty much all of our DMs from our show accounts, producer Clark. He texted me. He says, you better answer this from Trevor Harris. So I went in, looked, and Trevor Harris, he wants my ultimate quarterback, best arm, best football IQ, best feet, best swagger. And he goes, and you better not put any Saskatchewan bias in there. So I'm Trevor Harris.
Wow.
So I said, just hang on. On Friday, we'll go deep. So you guys all, because we're going to do hockey right after this break. Tomorrow's all football. I want you all to be thinking about who's your ultimate quarterback, taking pieces of all of them in the CFL. Trevor Harris is going to be watching tomorrow, tuned in. So that was pretty cool. Exchanged some very nice messages. He's just a first-class guy. Kind of guy you want to cheer for.
Yeah.
So that's the rollout for Flooring Superstore. We covered a little bit of everything, but not a lot of anything. We'll get into that and more when we come back. Jason Strudwick from TSN 1260 Edmonton will be with us. It's the Rod Pedersen Show, Facebook Live, Game Plus, TV Network, and listen live at rodpedersen.com.
You're watching Rod Pedersen On Demand. For more of the Rod Pedersen Show, visit rodpedersen.com or follow Rod Pedersen on social media.